Our Maker has made knowing who His two witnesses are the very simple matter of believing the testimony or the witness of His Word. In the revelations of His Son, chapter 11, Yahweh tells us that His two witnesses are two olive trees that are standing before His faces in association with two golden candlesticks. These two golden candlesticks are referring to the two branches of His golden candlestick. Yahweh's servant Zechariah was also shown these two olive trees that are standing beside the golden candlestick. When he was, he asked Yahweh's messenger, "Who are these two olive trees?" This is recorded in Zechariah chapter 4, verse 4. And then in verse 5, we are told that Yahweh's messenger then asked him, "Don't you know who these two olive trees are?" Zechariah answered, "No, master." Then the Most High's messenger told him, "This is Yahweh's word that is upon Zerubbabel, saying, 'Not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit,'" referring to by Yahweh's seven sets of dual eyes per verse 10, says Yahweh of hosts. This is recorded in verse 6. Yahweh's servant Zechariah asked Yahweh's messenger who these two olive trees that are standing before the golden candlestick are, and his messenger gives him the name of one of them in verse 6, and then he gives him the name of the other in verse 7. His messenger continued on in verse 7 saying, "Who are you, great mountain? You will become a plain before Zerubbabel's faces, and he will journey forth with the headstone or with the chief stone, with shoutings or with crying outs of favor, favor unto him." This is not difficult. The Most High shows his two olive trees to his servant Zechariah, and then he has his messenger tell him who they are by name, Zerubbabel and the headstone. He goes on in verse 14 to tell his servant Zechariah that they are the two sons of his holy anointing oil that stand before the faces of the master of all of the earth. Another perfect match to Revelation chapter 11. Zerubbabel means one who flows out from Babylon, referring to mystery Babylon at this time. No one who is in the blasphemous religion of Christianity would refute that the headstone is referring to the Most High's only begotten Son. Yahweh caused his entire word to be written upon these two sons of his holy anointing oil, particularly the second of them. The testimony of his word clearly identifies the one who is speaking to you as this servant Zerubbabel, the one who has flowed out from the captivity of mystery Babylon. And so does the work that he has sent me with these past going on 14 years since beginning to pluck this brand from your midst. The arrogance that you have in denying this basic fundamental reality of his word is off the charts. Who do any of you think that you are to speak or to even think differently than that which the Almighty El's word clearly testifies to? The way that the rest of Yahweh's word testifies on my behalf and also on behalf of his only begotten Son, is absolutely incredible. Your proof that I am not this servant is merely that my Father has continued to shorten the days through afflicting me in your stead. This is your only proof, even though his word also tells us that he was going to send me to you in the manner that he has. Your arrogance and your bitterly obstinate hearts are indeed off the charts. You believe that he afflicted his first witness in your stead, but not his second witness. Go figure. His word even tells us that you were going to use the excuse that which I have spoken has not come to pass in order to justify your remaining turned aside from him. This is recorded in These Are the Truths, a.k.a. the erroneously named book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18. You can look up the words for yourself. As for his only begotten Son being his first witness, Yeshua even told Pilate that this was the reason that he was born, the night before he was killed. The rest of the revelations of his Son, chapter 11, are also a perfect match to the manner that he has sent his two sons of his holy anointing oil into the world. Granted, there are some things that the Most High has continued to hold back as part of him shortening the days. As for our smiting the earth with all plagues, whenever it is that we desire, our heart's desire is that you would turn back to our Father before he smites you to cause you to do so. This is obviously his desire as well. This is why he has sent us in his, all of his prophets, with wave after wave of warning, wave after waves of warnings. This is why he has set his, he has shortened the days. This is why he has afflicted his two sons in your stead. Our desire is that you would obey him out of a love for his righteousness and out of a desire to please him. However, there is also the reality that has come to pass that you have refused to turn back to having such a heart as this.